Now, let us open our Little Thinker Environmental Studies book to page 14. Let's see what we have to do. Color the box green where water is used properly, and color the box red if the water is wasted. So what we have to do, we have to color the box green if it is used properly and red if it is not used properly. Right, children? So I'm sure your red and green crayons are also ready with you. Now in the first picture, what you can do, what you can see, the boy is drinking water. So is it good or bad? Yes, absolutely it is good. So we will color it green. Now in the next picture, the girl is watering with the water can. So is it good or bad? Yes, it is a good thing. So it is being used properly. So we color it green. Now in the next one, the boy is brushing. By the time the boy is brushing, the water is? Yes, he's left the tap open and the water is getting wasted. So is it good or bad? Not good. So we have to color the box red. So we color the box red. Now the next one, yes, you can see a leaking tap also. So that is also not good. So we color it again red. Now moving on to the next one, somebody's washing the vegetables with water. So that is a very good habit. We should wash the vegetables with water. So we color it again green. Now the next one, the water from the water tank, water is oozing out. Moving out, yes, and getting splashed and wasted. So is it good? No, not good. So we color it red again. So in this manner, we will finish our Little Thinker Environmental Studies page 14. Color it green where it is used properly, like the person drinking water, watering the plant, or washing the vegetables. That is good. So we will color it green. But then where the water is tap is leaking, or he's just wasting water left when he's brushing, or even the water is coming out from the truck, that is not good. So that time we color it with red. So now children, we'll open up our memories book to page number 23. Let's see what we have to do there. So now let's open, we have opened to page number 23. Let's see what we have to do. Discuss with your child the ways to save water at home as a family and write them here. So I've already told you the different ways we can save water. Now let's see at home what are the different ways we at times waste water. So now let's, as a family, as a group together, let us write the different ways we can save water. Right, children?